Hello, anatomy colleagues. This is Dr. Alsup, and let's discuss the femoral triangle. So in this learning objective video, we will list the boundaries, but we will also importantly describe the contents of the femoral triangle, as these are some fairly large structures. They can be palpable, or certain components of them are, and they're vitally important to the lower limb. So the femoral triangle is located in the superomedial thigh region, so closely associated with the groin region, close to the abdominal region, basically at the superior portion of the lower limb. And it appears as a triangle, a kind of a triangular depression inferior to the inguinal ligament. So recall that that inguinal ligament is going to be the external oblique aponeurosis that extends from the ases, or anterior superior iliac spine, to the pubic tubercle. And the inguinal ligament will serve as the superior boundary of the femoral triangle. The lateral boundary is the sartorius muscle, which extends all the way from the coxal bone all the way to the tibia. In fact, this is the longest muscle in the body, but it will also serve as the lateral boundary of the femoral triangle. The adductor longus is going to be the medial boundary, one of the muscles of the medial or adductor compartment. And the floor of the femoral triangle rests on two deeper muscles of the anterior thigh region. You'll have the iliopsoas, as well as the iliopsoas is going to be kind of more laterally placed, and the pectineus will be more medially placed. It's not quite as visible here because it's being blocked by the contents of the femoral triangle. So let's talk a little bit more about those contents. There are three major neurovascular structures that are contained within the femoral triangle, but the medial most portion of the femoral triangle actually contains the femoral canal, which is in this basic region right here. Really, the femoral canal is a small area mainly containing adipose tissue, but it does have some, but not all, of the deep inguinal lymph nodes. Continuing to move from medial to lateral, we get to the bigger structures, starting with the femoral vein. The femoral vein is the continuation of the popliteal vein, so both are considered deep veins, even though at this level, the femoral vein is very superficially located. The femoral vein will become the external iliac vein past the inguinal ligament. The femoral artery is going to be just lateral to the femoral vein. This artery is the continuation of the external iliac artery, past the inguinal ligament and is the dominant supply to the lower limb. And it actually gives off its largest branch, the deep artery of the thigh, within the inguinal triangle. The most lateral structure, large structure, is going to be the femoral nerve, which is the largest branch of the lumbar plexus and will be the dominant supply to the anterior thigh, as well as having cutaneous innervation supply in a multitude of areas, and we'll talk about that in more detail in upcoming sessions. And it will give off numerous branches within the femoral triangle, as this is kind of trying to represent here. I often remember the order of these structures through the mnemonic VAN, which tells you from medial to lateral, so this is from medial to lateral, the order of the structures, or those largest neurovascular structures, so vein, artery, nerve. You may see in some of your study guides, like first aid, the mnemonic navel, which goes into a bit more detail, but it's kind of in the reverse, so it's going from lateral to medial, so lateral to medial. And what this is, the mnemonic is indicating that the nerve is the most lateral, arteries next, vein, then it's talking about the empty space associated with the femoral canal, and then the lymphatics are going to be the L. So that's what the navel mnemonic is getting at. So a few things I want us to consider about this area, and these are reasons that this area is often discussed. First, and probably most importantly, the pulsations of the femoral artery are palpable within the triangle due to its relatively superficial position deep to the deep fascia. And this can be useful for a multitude of reasons, including, first of all, getting a femoral pulse, but also, since the femoral vein is not typically palpable even here, knowing the relationships, or that geographic relationship of the femoral triangle can help one understand where the femoral vein is as well. So it's going to be just medial to the femoral artery. And that can be important in getting blood samples, taking pressure recordings, femoral vein cannulation. Those are a few things where that could be useful. Additionally, I want to note that the femoral artery and vein, as well as the femoral canal, are going to be wrapped up in what is referred to as the femoral sheath. And this sheath is pretty robust. It will actually extend deep to the inguinal canal, allowing that femoral vasculature to glide deep to the inguinal ligament, particularly during movements of the hip joint. Often during dissection, it is difficult to differentiate between the artery and the vein because it is so tightly wrapped, they are both so tightly wrapped together in this femoral sheath. Lastly, at the base of the femoral canal, you will have this area, which I'm circling here, that's referred to as the femoral ring. It's an oval ring-like shape. It's a relatively weak area associated with the inguinal triangle region, and it's most typically the originating site of a femoral hernia. So it is at this femoral ring, like right here at the base of the femoral canal, that you most commonly have femoral hernias, which is a herniation or protrusion of abdominal viscera through the femoral ring and into the femoral canal. It is observable. If it is observable, it'll be present as kind of a small bulge in the medial femoral triangle region. The herniation, as you can imagine, can compress the other contents of the femoral canal. So a small but important area of the anterior superior limb. Please take time to review the boundaries and contents and reach out if you have any questions. Thank you for your time and attention.